This is Bishop George Murray. On behalf of your Catholic friends and neighbors in the Diocese of Youngstown, I invite you to join us for this celebration of the Holy Mass.
Good morning, and welcome to our celebration of Holy Mass. Today is the fifth Sunday of Easter. Our celebrant is Father Larry Frient, pastor of St. Paul the Apostle Church in New Middletown. I'm Carol Geise from St. Christine Parish in Youngstown. As we pray this Mass, let us remember in our prayers Joseph Smith.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Jesus tells us that he is the true vine. We are the branches. His Father is the vine grower. We believe him, and apart from him, we can do nothing. We place our trust in his goodness, the ways in which he wants us to be nourished by him, and even in the ways he challenges us to be better disciples. Lord Jesus, your Father is the vine grower. Enable us to appreciate God's goodness. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you are the true vine. Apart from you, we can do nothing. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you enable us to bear fruit and to be your disciples. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, constantly accomplish the Paschal mystery within us, that those you were pleased to make new in holy baptism may under your protective care bear much fruit and come to the joys of life eternal. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. When Saul arrived in Jerusalem, he tried to join the disciples, but they were all afraid of him, not believing that he was a disciple. Then Barnabas took charge of him and brought him to the apostles, and he reported to them how he had seen the Lord and that he had spoken to him, and how in Damascus he had spoken out boldly in the name of Jesus. He moved freely about with them in Jerusalem and spoke out boldly in the name of the Lord. He also spoke and debated with Hellenists when they tried to kill him. And when the brothers learned of this, they took him down to Caesarea and sent him on his way to Tarsus. The church throughout all Judea, Galilee, and Samaria was at peace. It was being built up and walked in the fear of the Lord. And with the consolation of the Holy Spirit, it grew in numbers. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I will praise you, Lord, in the assembly of your people.
I will praise you, Lord, in the assembly of your people.
I will fulfill my vows before those who fear the Lord. The lowly shall eat their fill. They will seek the Lord, shall praise him. May your hearts live forever.
I will praise you, Lord, in the assembly of your people.
All the ends of the earth shall remember and turn to the Lord. All the families of the nations shall bow down before him. I will praise you, Lord, in the assembly of your people. To him alone shall bow down all who sleep in the earth, Before him shall bend all who go down into the dust. I will praise you, Lord, in the assembly of your people. To him my soul shall live, and my descendants shall serve him. Let the coming generation be told of the Lord, that they may proclaim to a people yet to be born the justice he has shown. I will praise you, Lord, in the assembly of your people. A reading from the first letter of St. John. Children, let us love not in word or in speech, but in deed and in truth. Now this is how we shall know that we belong to the truth and reassure our hearts before him in whatever our hearts condemn. For God is greater than our hearts and knows everything. Beloved, if our hearts do not condemn us, we find confidence in God and receive from him whatever we ask. Because we ask, we keep his commandments and do what pleases him. And his commandment is this: we shall believe in the name of his Son, Jesus Christ, and love one another, just as he has commanded us. Those who keep his commandments remain in him, and he in them. And the way we shall know that he remains in us is from the Spirit he has given us. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. The Lord be with you.
And with your
spirit. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, I am the true vine, and my Father is the vine grower. He takes away every branch in me that does not bear fruit, and every one that does, he prunes so that it bears more fruit. You are already pruned because of the word that I spoke to you. Remain in me as I remain in you. Just as a branch cannot bear fruit on its own unless it remains on the vine, so neither can you unless you remain in me. I am the vine. You are the branches. Whoever remains in me and I in him will bear much fruit, because without me, you can do nothing. Anyone who does not remain in me will be thrown out like a branch and wither. People will gather them and throw them into a fire, and they will be burned. If you remain in me, and my words remain in you, ask for whatever you want, and it will be done for you. By this is my Father glorified, that you bear much fruit and become my disciples. The Gospel of the Lord. Sometimes people boastfully say, I have connections. Well, the truth is, all of us do. Think about how many invitations we receive to join LinkedIn or other social media. And even when it comes to religion, it's very much a matter of connections. Think about the word religion. It's all about connections. It comes from a word that is like the word ligament, which connects two bones or cartilages to hold in place a joint. The author G.K. Chesterton said, a man can no more possess a private religion than he can possess a private sun or moon. It's all about connections. Connections are inevitable. It's impossible to be totally isolated. And we think about the truth that we have such connectivity with all humanity. Many people enjoy studying their roots, genealogy. Many people take DNA tests to check out their ancestry. Now consider the fact that each of us has two parents, each of them had two parents, and we can keep going back to each of their parents having two parents, and on and on. And by the time you go back 500 or 600 years, you find that you have millions of ancestors, And whether or not we realize it, we have connections with them. Millions of unknown characters are dancing in our DNA, waltzing with our chromosomes, fiddling with our genetic makeup. So what connection does all of this have with today's gospel? Well, each of our ancestors, all of these people with whom we have connections in his way or her own way, thought about God, or perhaps struggled with God, or maybe tried their best to ignore God. And ultimately, we find that everyone is striving for wholeness of life. And where do we find it? Jesus spells it out so well in today's gospel. He says, "I am the true vine. My Father is the vine grower. You are the branches." Wholeness cannot be achieved by our own power. Connections are essential. And furthermore, Jesus says, "Remain in me as I remain in you. Whoever remains in me and I in him, or I in her, will bear much fruit, because without me, you can do nothing." And last Sunday's first reading, we were told that Jesus is the cornerstone of our faith. In last Sunday's gospel, Jesus told us that he is the good shepherd. And today, in the gospel we just heard, Jesus tells us that he is the true vine. We are the branches. So our true ancestry, our best connection, is that value of being a part of the vine that is the body of Christ. Jesus says, "Remain in him." He could also use the word "abide," or literally, "make your home in me as I make my home in you." So Jesus is all about relationships, all about connectivity, all about growing closer to him and us growing closer to one another. And even though in one sense we don't choose whether or not we bear fruit, because some of it's up to God and some of it's up to how people respond, we do have choices to make constantly. We choose to stay connected with Jesus. We choose to let Jesus remain in us. In the Apostles' Creed, we find such great connectivity, the communion of saints. So many people, for so many years, finding such great value in being connected with Jesus and with other believers. So the best we can do, perhaps, is pay it forward. Remain in Jesus. Let him remain in us. Let God be in charge of our LinkedIn network as we journey through life. Let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Trusting in God's goodness and guidance, we present our petitions.
For all the Holy Church,
that through pruning and purification it may bear much fruit. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Christians of every church and denomination, that these various branches of the true vine may increase in unity and their members may find common ground, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For missionaries like St. Paul, who speak out boldly in the name of the Lord, may they see their efforts bear fruit. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For farmers and ranchers, vine growers and orchardists, for all those whose work brings food and drink to our table, that they may be blessed in their labors. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who feel lonely and abandoned, that they may feel the comfort of knowing that they are part of a vine that has many branches and many connections. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, look with love on the prayers of your people and answer us according to your will. For we pray in the name of Jesus, our Lord. Amen. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands and for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
O God, who by this wonderful exchange effected in this sacrifice have made us partakers of the one supreme Godhead, grant, we pray, that as we have come to know your truth, we may make it ours by a way of life. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. He never ceases to offer himself for us, but defends us and ever pleads our cause before you. He is the sacrificial victim who dies no more, the Lamb once slain who lives forever. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim, Holy,
holy,
holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. for this is my body which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Joseph and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and George, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always and with you. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you. Thank you. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. The body of Christ.
Amen.
The blood of Christ.
Amen.
Let us pray. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those you have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in peace.